Tim Erlin, Vice President of Product Management and Strategy at Tripwire, and I'm here to talk about the 7 habits that make up a highly effective vulnerability management program. So let's get right to those 7 habits. The first one is executive buy-in. Now, it may seem like executive buy-in is sort of a gimme in this context, but I have seen a lot of vulnerability management programs ultimately fail because they didn't really have executive buy-in. So what does that mean? It means that the success or failure of that program is actually material. It matters to those executives, not just lip service, but that it affects their success or failure in some way. So if you can't figure out how your vulnerability management program impacts those executives, you probably don't have executive buy-in. The second habit that I see in organizations is asset discovery. So vulnerability management begins with understanding what's in your environment, because those are the assets in which you have to find those vulnerabilities. I've seen a lot of organizations that roll out a VM program, but they continually find exceptions or areas that they don't know what the assets are, where they're missing information about what they're actually trying to protect. So if you don't start with asset discovery, then you're not going to build a highly effective vulnerability management program. The third habit is scan frequency. Now, you might think that scan frequency means scanning as often as you possibly can, but it's important that scan frequency actually be rational rather than just as frequent as possible. And when I say rational, what I mean is that it be tied to the remediation activities that are going on in your organization as well. Scanning more frequently might not make any difference if your remediation cycle is much slower. So you want to have that rational connection between the frequency at which you're assessing those assets and the frequency at which you're actually remediating them. And then the fourth habit is incorporating business context. All assets are not created equal in an environment. So if you can't identify which assets are important to the business when you're performing vulnerability assessment, then you can't really manage those vulnerabilities effectively. You're simply assessing them, you're not managing them. So business context includes how important that asset is. It also includes what systems that asset participates in and how important those systems are to the business. So that's an important aspect, an important habit that I see in highly effective vulnerability management programs. The next habit is that exceptions are the exception. So what does that mean? In many environments, there are some assets that you can't effectively scan for vulnerabilities. Maybe they're old, maybe they fall over, maybe they're sensitive. Maybe the business unit simply doesn't accept that process. Maybe they're part of an industrial control system. But in organizations that have a highly effective vulnerability management program, those kinds of exceptions are really the exception. The more of that surface area that you exclude from vulnerability scanning, the more of that surface area you don't understand the risk on, and you're missing that information. So that's important. And then the sixth habit I see in organizations is managing to metrics. It's very easy with vulnerabilities to think that finding more is better and think that simply fixing more is better as well. But if you don't actually understand what metrics around vulnerabilities matter to your business, how your business operates, and if you're not tracking metrics other than simply how many vulnerabilities did we find or how many did we fix, then you're not really measuring if you're reducing risk effectively or not. So organizations that have highly effective vulnerability management programs tend to identify a set of metrics that make sense to the business, that motivate the right kinds of behavior in terms of remediation activity, and then use those metrics as management tools. And then finally, the 7th habit that I see for highly effective vulnerability management programs is an attachment or a connection to remediation workflow. There are many vulnerability management programs that I will call vulnerability assessment programs in these cases, where scans are run, vulnerabilities are found, they're handed off to other groups, but nothing really happens with those vulnerabilities. Nobody really fixes them effectively. Any risk mitigation is incidental. If your vulnerability scanning and vulnerability assessment isn't connected to a remediation workflow or a remediation process, you're not effectively managing those vulnerabilities. And there's no one size fits all for remediation. Organizations get work done differently. And so for you to connect your vulnerability assessment to that remediation workflow, you have to understand how your organization gets work done. And that kind of a connection is the last of the 7 habits that I see in highly effective vulnerability.